Welcome to this introductory video about Crown Green Bowling. It is designed specifically for those players who have just joined the Bowl for Health programme. It is designed to reinforce some of the basic principles that have been demonstrated to you by your club coach. Before we actually get into the game itself, we will describe two basic features of the game of Crown Green Bowls. The first is the shape of the green. It is not flat like lawn bowls. It has a bump or crown in the middle. Some greens are almost perfectly shaped, like the one you're seeing now. Others are less so. All crown greens have their unique features, which confers a distinct competitive disadvantage on visiting teams. Over time, home players get to know these idiosyncrasies and use them to great advantage. Second feature of the game of crown green bowls is the characteristic of the bowl itself. The bowl used in crown green bowls has a bias, which is created by the shape of the bowl. The bias causes the bowl to veer from a straight line if sent or delivered on a perfectly flat green. The bias side of the bowl is recognised by a slight indentation. For the serious-minded, the jack used in crown green bowls has what is technically known as a two-full bias, and all bowls have this same bias. We start with two club members playing a game of bowls. In this sequence, you will note the customary etiquette of greeting your opponent with a handshake, tossing a coin to decide who takes the jack and delivers the first bowl. There are three things to note when the first player delivers his bowl. You must have one foot on the mat when you deliver the bowl. You can remain in that position until your bowl comes to a rest, but then you must move to the side to let your opponent deliver his or her bowl. Once you have delivered your second bowl, you can start walking, but be very careful that you do not obscure the line of sight of your opponent. Once both players have reached the completed end, they must be careful not to touch a bowl until it is decided who has won the end. The winner is the player with a bowl, or possibly two bowls, nearest the jack. If the two players cannot agree, then they will call for pegs, and two non-players will assist using a measure, and this will be demonstrated later. The winner takes the jack, and the two continue playing until one player reaches the winning score of 21. Those are the two basic rudiments of a game of crown green bowls. We will now demonstrate a number of aspects in more detail. The skill in crown green bowling is manoeuvring your bowl across the green to a position closer to the jack than your opponent. The challenge is trying to work out how to use both the bias of the bowl and contour of the green to get as close as you can to the jack and to make it difficult for your opponent to follow. Choosing the right bowl is very important. Bowl size is defined by weight. They vary in size from 2 pounds to 2 pounds 12 ounces. The latter is referred to colloquially as 2 12s. The bowl should fit comfortably into your palm of your hand, and one simple test of whether the bowl is too big or heavy is to turn your hand over. If you feel the bowl is going to slip out of your grip, then this might suggest you need a lighter weight bowl. According to a local retailer, there is a clear trend towards players choosing the lighter weight bowls. The aim, however, is to find a bowl that you are comfortable with.
We'll now demonstrate some aspects of bowling. The first aspect will be holding the bowl. There are two main methods of holding the bowl. Some bowlers like to cradle the bowl in the palm of their hand with the thumb on the left, on the right, and the finger on the other side. Others like to cradle the bowl in the palm of the hand with the thumb on top of the bowl. The two circles at the side of the bowl should be vertical and in line with the land. The arm has got to be as low as possible to the floor and in line with the land. The next aspect is getting the land. The land is the path that the jack takes when it is delivered by the bowler. When the jack is delivered finger, it will generally veer to the left. If it's sent thumb, it will veer to the right. The contour of the green could defy this general rule.
Getting the land is the traditional term used by players to describe the trajectory of the ball across the green. When you are delivering a ball, there are two things to consider. In what direction are you going to send it, which is called the land, and how hard you're going to send it, which is referred to as the weight. This is where skill comes into the game, judging where to send your ball and how hard to send it. One method used by top class bowlers is to follow these basic rules. Whether you are sending the jack or just waiting your turn, watch as closely as possible where the jack has travelled. You are going to do your best to replicate that route. To help you, try and identify a mark on the green through which the jack has travelled, somewhere between 1 and 3 metres in front of you. When it is your turn, try to send your ball over the same mark. Remember, if you are a right-handed and your opponent is left-handed, these rules do not apply. This is a skill that only comes with practice and experience. Sometimes it is difficult to judge which bowls are closest to the jack after all bowls have been sent. Under these circumstances, one of the players will ask for pegs, and a representative from each team will use a measuring device to determine who has won the end. Their decision is final, and players should not interfere with the process or challenge the decision. Finally, the game of Crown Green Bowls is enhanced if players observe some basic rules of etiquette or good manners. Try to remember these 4 simple rules. If you are playing in a match, you welcome your opponent onto the green with introductions and a handshake. If you are playing a match against a visiting team, it is normal for your visitor to have first use of the jack. This may vary according to the nature of the competition. During the match, and after you have delivered your ball, you should not obscure the vision of your opponent who will be trying to follow the trajectory of your ball. At the end of the match, it is a normal convention to shake hands accompanied with a few words of congratulation or commiseration.